welcome back to my channel. If you're new to the channel, what's up? What's popping? This is me. I'm Samia, for those who don't know. So for today's video, I'm actually in a rush, y'all. So like, I really can't even be talking to y'all like that for real. Even though this is a girl chat, this is going to be more of like a... Okay, a chat seems short. Okay, yeah, a girl chat. That's exactly what it's going to be. A quick little... You know, we're not going to be discussing a whole bunch because... Hold on. Ew, I'm sorry, I'm in the bathroom. I'm sorry, I forgot I was thirsty. Like, that's on me. I know, that's on me. I'm thirsty, my bad, my fault. I'm gonna put the toilet seat down. Safe, okay. Anyway, we are rushing. Today's video, we're gonna be doing a girl chat. Like I just said, I'm already wasting time. And I'm also gonna be doing a get ready with me. I'm about to go take some pictures. I wanted y'all to see what I'm about to do because why not? Like, y'all be... Come along. Come along for the ride. Let's do it. Also, come on. First, show you guys my options for hair today. That's what we're going to be Okay, maybe I should start off with getting dressed because, again, wasting time. Let me show y'all these first, and then we're going to figure out what we're going to do. So, these are two ponytails. They are from insert name here. The first one is this wavy one. I'm trying to figure out which one. Because I think it all just really depends on the fit to the, you know, like to figure out what type of vibe I'm going for. So it's like a easy, here you take these bobby pins off and you know, you attach. I'm gonna show y'all how to do it when I get to my hair. It's gonna be really easy. It's gonna take like 5 minutes. I've seen like all the little videos that they had on their Instagram page and it seems really simple. That's really cute. But I think maybe, I don't know, okay. I don't know. I gotta figure out the fit. But let me show y'all the straight hair too. Let me tell y'all the reason I'm in a rush as well. Cause I know y'all are like, slow down, what's the hurry? Well, let me show you the straight first. So cute. Like, it's so soft. It feels like my hair. I don't know. I don't know, we're about to see. We're gonna make it cute when it's time for it. All of the ponytails come with a scrunchie you can put around with it too. But let's kinda get into this Q&A some so I can answer while I... You know, I'm getting ready. It's really gonna be like y'all on a FaceTime call with me today because I don't have time for, you know, the setups and the ring lights and everything right now because I wanna make content for y'all, but I also gotta hurry up because the sun sets at like 1 p.m. now, so I gotta really pick up the pace. It's 4:40 already. It'd be pitch dark outside at like 6:30. Come on, we gotta go, y'all. All right, so I'm in my closet now. I'm about to pick out my fit, and I'm just going to answer some questions for y'all while I try to figure out what I want to wear in these pictures in a matter of, like, 5 minutes or so. Not answering all the questions in 5 minutes, but definitely picking out a fit in 5 minutes. The first question was, how to be comfortable with being alone, especially when you have no friends? I like to keep myself busy. I like to find things that I like to do, you know, like I've learned so much about myself being alone. I really get to do things that I haven't done in a long time, like reading, like writing more and journaling and making notes of this and going to walk here and do that, like paint and color. Like I found different things that interest me so I don't ever feel like too lonely. Of course, I have times where I'm like, dang, I miss my friends. Dang, I miss my boyfriend. But I'm never like, oh, I'm so bored that I just, you know, can't do anything in my life. Girl, go find a gym or something. Go work out. Like, find something to make you better during, like, your times of being by yourself. Because I feel like that the enemy wants to make you feel like you can't do anything by yourself. I feel like that used to be one of my problems. I don't know why I can't do it at the same time. But I think I want to do these pants. They're boyfriend jeans. I got them. Don't mind the ankle. They were, they're gonna get ironed. Don't worry about that. Let's just slide it down. I got these from Walmart. Please don't play with Walmart. She's not one of them. The enemy wants you to feel like, you know, you by yourself, you can't do anything. And that was one of my things like, oh, I'm gonna get my nails done. Let me go ask somebody if they wanna get their nails done with me. Oh, I'm gonna go here. Let me go ask somebody if they wanna do this with me. You don't always need somebody to do something with you. You gotta learn to really love yourself, really learn yourself to find out what you like to do, find out where you like to be, where you like to go, so you're confident in these places. I don't need anybody to go anywhere with me. Like, I'll throw my AirPods and I'll be, shoot, I'm in a music video. This is my world. Y'all are just living in it. Like, y'all are extras. You feel me? That's how I be feeling. You better come on. You better find something to enjoy yourself to. I be in the gym, like, look, I'm doing my thing. You feel me? Like,
I'm not even worried about no being lonely. But for like the friends thing, like I feel like friends come, like don't force the friends. Like that's one thing that I was like, I'm not finna do. I'm not gonna force a friendship. You know, like anything that's supposed to happen will happen. And I feel like anytime you force something, that's when things go, you know, not how they supposed to go. Like, dang, this could all been avoided if I would have just stayed in my own lane. I don't know if I want to do like a graphic tee or like, cause it's hot here still. Like, I know y'all are experiencing the cold and it can't relate, but nah, but it's a good 80 degrees outside still. So I'm like, I don't know if I want to do a crop top or like, and then I got to think I'm about to have a ponytail. You know what I'm saying? You got to think of the whole vibe. Like, what do I want to do? Okay, boyfriend jeans and what? Boyfriend jeans and who? Which one of y'all gonna be in the pictures? Okay, but seriously, come on, soft. Ponytail and boyfriend jeans. I just feel like maybe the boyfriend jeans are throwing me off. Because, like, ponytail, I'm giving... And boyfriend jeans are giving me like two different vibes. But I can make it work. Let me think. Come on, stop. The sun is going away. Come on. How do you know when your friends are real or not? Okay, so this is a big question because I feel like I was just talking to some of my friends the other day. Like, I have friend PTSD. It's real. I don't ever want to... Come say these say, be happy for myself all the way because I'm so used to, like, not all the time. I'm not saying all my friends, you know, like, you my friend, do you know? Like, don't quit being like that. I've had friends where it's like, you say something good going in your life, like, okay, girl, we get it. Like, oh, my bad, like, my fault. I don't like to tell all of myself all the time either because, like, with back to the friend PTSD, it's like, there were girls who was seriously praying on my downfall. But then also asking me to hang out in that same day. Like, how'd that work? It doesn't. Oh, this is cute. Good vibe, it's tan. And I could do like, I really wish I had those tan Jordan 4s. What the freak, Corey. Baby, like, but for real, no, I'm serious. I really need the tan Jordan 4s, size 7.5. Ja'Cory Crawford. I know you're watching this right now. Yeah, it'll be cute. I just gotta do my edges really cute. To really like, okay, cool. The shoes. Back to the friends. I really found out, like, when it comes to friends, like, I'm, like I just previously said for the question before, I don't force it. You don't gotta be friends with me. You don't gotta kick it with me. I'm reading the situation always. Like, I'm paying attention to the details now because I think my mistake in the beginning was not paying attention to the details. I ignored red flags when I saw them, even though I felt, you know, how I did about them. Not saying them, like, as in the person, but them as in the red flags. Like, okay. Like, I just kind of... Oh, but they're cool. Oh, but they're funny. Oh, but they're nice sometimes. Oh, but they're this. And yeah. They're really your friends or not? You'll know. Like, but you gotta wanna know. You feel me? Like, when I say you gotta wanna know, you gotta be paying attention. Like, you can't just be so quick to, oh yeah, this is my best friend ever. Like, yeah, we're best friends. Y'all met 3 weeks ago. How y'all best friends? Like, stop letting everybody get the power to be able to call themselves your best friend. A lot of y'all be doing that in relationships too. Don't give everybody the power to be like, oh yeah, Savion's my best friend. Savion's my girlfriend. Like, you gotta be coming with it. Because at the end of the day, you walking out, you representing me out there. You know what I'm saying? And I'm talking to people like, oh yeah, Corey's my boyfriend. I gotta be able to know, like, oh yeah, Corey, good people. You feel me? You letting people be able to be your best friend, best? And it's the same girl that be jumping up on tables, yelling and screaming, punching people, jumping off, knocking people out. And this your best friend. Okay. Oh, I didn't even show y'all the shoes for real. I just wanted to back y'all up, son. Cause I told y'all we on FaceTime today. This is not a regular video. This is a FaceTime call. So do not accept anything more than that.
I'm about to turn that light off because I was about to say because I don't pay no bills, but I do actually pay the bills, so I gotta go turn that light off. But we're gonna go to the third question. What is your ideal vacation? My ideal vacation would be something like, I don't know what I'm doing. Hold on, let me do this first because I obviously can't do all this at one time. I would want to go somewhere that's like hot. I don't like the cold. Like, if you're new to the channel, I do not do the cold. Like, that's one of my pet peeves. Like, please don't let me be cold. Preferably a beach. But I'm cool, like, if it's, like, not a beach, like, we've already done enough beaches for the month, like, oh, yeah, let's hit up, you know, Italy or something, like, somewhere that's not, like, a beach place. Like, we can go somewhere like that, and I would be perfectly fine as well. But, yeah, I don't know if I'm going to be able to reach, actually. Is this going to be able to reach this far? Yeah, here we go. Here it is. All right, next question. Hold on. Maybe she didn't leave that on there like that.
Stupid!
What has it been like for you as a woman since moving if you don't have people there that you know? It's been cool. Like I said from the first question, like, I've really just been learning myself. Like, just knowing, you know me now. And I like it because it's like, this is my environment now. Like, this is my space. If it's dirty, it's because I didn't clean it up. If I'm hungry, I gotta go get my own food. Everything I gotta do is for me now. So it's like, it's no excuses for anything. You just kind of gotta do it. But like, I just been trying to like focus on what I need to be better at. And let me just say a big tip for, I guess, really just like staying productive. It's keeping a journal, bro. Ever since I started keeping my journal and just like writing, not even just like writing my every day to day, you know, feelings or anything like that, not even on no diary type thing. I mean, you can definitely do that as well because you definitely want to be aware of how you're feeling mentally, emotionally, spiritually is gonna be like the main thing you write it down. So, but like mentally, emotionally, you want to write all of that for sure. But I keep like a track of everything in there. Like everything, all my thoughts, well, not all my thoughts, but like those ones that, you know, you just don't want to have in your mind no more. Like, let me just write this down, bro. Let me figure out how I can, you know, find a solution to this, how I can get better in this. Or I'll write down things like a to-do list. Okay, this is what we're getting done today. You know, it's just whatever I feel I'm supposed to write that day. Some days I write morning affirmations. Some days I take my notes from church in there, church, you know, or like sermons, online sermons in there. And it just depends. But keeping a journal allows me to be self-aware. And I always write the date down, like, you know, so I can see like, oh, I made it from here and now I'm here now. You know what I'm saying? Like, just keeping track of your progress. Because another thing that I feel like a lot of people overlook when it comes to motivation, that progress that you get, that progress is what's going to keep you going in what you're doing. Seeing that you're getting better, that's going to help you. But the thing is, you're never going to reach that progress if you don't start doing something. Feel me? Like, we can't be happy to go to the gym yet because we still sitting on the couch, you know? Like, you never going to be excited to go to the gym if all you're doing is looking how bad it is. You gotta start going. You gotta start working out. Like, oh, I look kind of good. I kind of want to go back to the gym. You feel me? Like, that's how you get excited about the things that at first you didn't really want to do. Danny's wrinkles really not trying to come out these pants. He's really here, like, to stay type of. But not today. We finna put our back into this. Like, wow. Dang, you know what I was thinking about, bro? When I was ironing my clothes the other day, I was like, ironing just automatically made me think about school, like growing up. Like early in the morning, my mom ironing the clothes for us, you know, to go to school type thing. Because me as a Savia, in my old place in Atlanta, if something was wrinkly, it's getting thrown right in the dryer. Like, I'm not pulling out no ironing board. Like, what am I pulling an ironing board for? Like, what do I need this for? The dryer can do the same thing while I'm getting ready. Like, two birds, one stone. I'm not using iron. But for this new place, I don't have a washer and dryer in the apartment. Like, I have to go, you know, to the, like, the building laundry room type thing. So I'm not finna walk up and down the stairs for a shirt. So Now we iron. But then, all that morning, school thinking, ironing and whatnot, made me think, like, one day I'm gonna have to iron my kids' clothes. Then I started thinking about kids. And then I just stopped thinking about ironing altogether. No, ma'am. I'm good. Long distance advice. Dang, I forgot I gotta iron a shirt too, bro. Dang. Pieces of advice that I can give those who are in a long distance relationship. I would first say it takes a lot of communication. Like, if you thought you had to communicate a lot when y'all were right next to each other, boy. Like, you need to talk about everything just about all the time. Let that person be aware of, you know, the life that you have going on here. Don't leave them in the dark for anything, because then that leaves room for overthinking. You don't want your partner to ever feel like they're not your priority. You don't ever want them to feel like you being sneaky, or, you know, trying to do something that you're not supposed to be doing, anything like that. So you just want to make sure that you're being fully transparent about, you know, things that you got going on, things that you're feeling, things that you're thinking. Like, just let them know. And a lot of times, I just want to say, like, you need to be able to say how you feel, even if you think it might hurt your partner's feelings. Like, because you got to be all the way real. They can't read your mind or give you no hug or read no body language. You feel what I'm saying? Like, or see your face even completely just over the phone or just through text message. So you got to let them know, like, look, baby, look, I'm feeling this, and this is why I'm feeling this way. Because you rather it, you know, feel a type of way for that little bit so y'all can fix it, or rather than you just kind of letting it go and letting that little bit build up on top of that little bit, on top of that little bit, and now it's a whole big thing that should have been stopped way back here. Like I tell my players, you should be over-communicating. It takes a lot of trust, for sure, a lot of trust. Not even just, like, for your partner. I feel like for me, it don't even be me worried about what Corey gonna do. It be me worried about the females around him and what they gonna do. Because y'all think y'all slick. And it be a lot of y'all watching these videos. And I'm not gonna do nothing crazy to you, because you know what? I'm a child of God. But just let me let you know that I see you. And I'm not worried about it. I'm really not even worried about y'all. I'm really not. But the thing is, y'all sneaky. And y'all like to do slick stuff. Not y'all. I'm not. Okay, look. Let me stop. Because, look, I don't want none of my fathers to be like, girl, I don't never even seen your man. I'm not talking to y'all, obviously. But I just know, like, there are females in Atlanta for sure. Because it's happened to me before, like, for previous boyfriends. Girl, the same girls that be underneath your picture talking about, oh my God, you're so cute. Oh my God, relationship goals, be the same one. As soon as y'all go for a little break, be all in your man's DMs. Oh, I thought it was you. Like, they don't know if they want to be your friend or take your man. And I don't like that. You feel me? That's where the friend PTSD start coming back in. That's why, you feel me? You see how it all just came around full circle? That's why. But anyway, long distance relationships. You want to keep it fun. You feel me? Remember why y'all started this in the first place. If y'all can make it work close, that distance really gonna test you. But keep it fun, bro. Me and Corey be having a blast. Swear. Like, yes, we be missing each other. Definitely be missing each other. But we be making it work. You know? Like, we be eating together on the phone, or we'll watch YouTube videos together. Like, okay, I'm starting at second 53. We'll start at the same time so we can watch it together. Like, it can work, but you have to work as well. You feel me? Like, you gotta make it work, because that's not something that comes easy. This is somebody who I went from seeing every single day to not. Like, I'm on week 3 and I got the shakes. Like, like, I cannot deal, and I still have to go another 3 weeks.
The nigga was too stunned to speak.
Anyway, it's cool though, because you know what? It's really letting me, you know, miss him. Because now when I see him, as soon as I see him, I'm jumping on him. I don't care. I will tag him in the airport. And I don't care. Because I miss him, bro. 3 weeks.
the longest me and Corey have ever been without each other was, it was the first summer, like, since we had gotten together. We had started dating in April 1st of 2018. And then we had that summer break, you know, in between, you know, summer. Hold on, Corey's calling me. 1 second, y'all. So I'm about done ironing this shirt. I really need to go. Like, it's really getting dark. What time is it? Okay. Good thing the hair is gonna be fast, because I really gotta go in like the next 30 minutes. Like, I don't know. I really need to leave in the next like 20 minutes. Okay. I'm gonna get dressed and see y'all in a minute. I feel like this isn't like up enough to be like, you know what I'm saying, for the braid that I'm about to have. But I think I'm going to add these sunglasses. You know, sunglasses always makes everything like, and this little bag I got from like Goodwill, just to be browns. And then I think that I'll add like, you know, some accessories to it. Then just like braid, I mean ponytail. I don't know though, we're gonna see.
I'm about to get on my hair and see where we go from there.
All right, so we're about to get into this braid. I mean, I keep calling it a braid because the only time I do like the long hair, the long ponytail type thing is when I have a long braid. That's not true. I've definitely done the long ponytail without the braid. So I just can't talk today, that's all. I'm not blaming anything else. Next question is, what are some things that you do to give back to, don't put that on there. What are some things that you do to get back to feeling like you in times when you don't feel like yourself? Honestly, the best thing that I've come across to make me feel like me again when I don't is fasting. And I think, I mean, that's a pretty, you know, I mean, drastic step to take, but I think that just brings me back to square one. Brings me back to the basics. Like, you're doing a little bit too much of the wrong things and not enough of the things you're supposed to do. That's what I feel like. Like, I'm doing too much of that and not enough of this. So I just get back to this. So I'll fast from things. And a lot of people think, like, when they hear the word fast, they just automatically think food. Like, there have been fasts that I've gone on where food has not even been mentioned. Like, you can fast from social media. You can fast from reality TV. You can fast from anything. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's one thing that for sure, if I'm not feeling like myself, let me just take away all these other distractions and all these other outside things to just really get back to me. But yeah. So for this ponytail, I just really want to focus on getting these fronts. You know what I'm saying? Sleek. Sleek type. Because, I don't know, we're about to see how this ponytail goes. I'm excited to try it out. I think I'm going to go with the... They're both super cute, right? I think I'm going to go with the wavy, though, just because I don't have time to straighten, like, the straight one. Because you saw how it was, like, I mean, I guess, like, no, I need to hurry up and go. Yeah, I'm going to just go with the wavy. And I hope it blends well. Oh, well, instead it kind of, like, goes around the ponytail. See, this is, like, the hardest thing to do with the straight hair is some ponytails. Like, why is that? Like, why is my hair straight and I'm having a hard time with this? I don't appreciate that at all. Like, who do you think you are? Like, the curls don't even give me this much trouble. What are you doing? Now I'm gonna have to start over. That really blows me. Is it good enough, or is it like we have to, you know, have to try it again? Let's see. You know what I'm saying? It's just gotta be good. No, I gotta do it again. Okay. Let's go to the next thing so I can just think about something else. Skincare question mark. I will be posting my skincare routine on TikTok, actually.
very soon. So if you don't follow me on TikTok, definitely go follow me on there. My at is Savion Gabrielle. Very similar to my Instagram, which is savion.gabrielle, where I will also be posting my skincare routine. I'm probably just gonna post it on there as a reel or something. But I actually have my skincare routine in my last video, if you wanna go see that as well. All right, so I'm really focused on this one. Here we go. Good, good. Oh no, I already see a freaking crinkle. All right, I don't even care. I don't even have time. So I'm just gonna brush. Brush and go. And then we're gonna start putting our product in the front. So get these flyaways to go down. And what is this though? Like, this bothers me. Like, you get what I'm saying? Like, y'all not bothered? I be bothered. Why is this here? I'm really tempted to just, but like, what if this was my 13th reason? Like, why are they not? Okay. I'm just going to let it ride out and I'm not even gonna care. And that's just what it is. So we're gonna start by getting our edge control, and I use Lay by Lyra. I really love this edge control. I did the wet look video with this a long time ago, and I went to go buy some more and the website was like down, and I was so sad, like, no, she doesn't sell it anymore. And then I walked into the beauty supply store one day and I was like, it's right here. I grabbed two. Like, no, I'm gonna need this, because it's like the only edge control for me that really, I don't know, like, really gets my hair and slicks it down like where I want it to be without it sliding later on in the day. This is not promo either, like, this is just straight like what I use, but like, keeps my hair slicked down and it holds like really well for my hair. I feel like Eco doesn't hold anything down. It's really just a waste of arm swoop. And I tried Edge Booster, and I had one Edge Booster that was similar like to this consistency and that was holding it down. And then I couldn't find that one ever again after that. I was like, why? What's up with me and finding good edge controls and then never being able to find them ever again? Like, I don't like that. But because I tried other edge controls from Edge Booster and I was okay, you know, can't be too, you know, different other than the smell. But no, it wasn't holding anything down. Dang, okay. See, look at my edges. Those are really cute. I also just looked outside and it's already dark. So I don't even know if this is really worth it anymore. What do you ask for when you get your lashes done? I usually get a hybrid set if I was in Atlanta, but I've been, this one that I had on right now, you can't even tell, but these are 3 weeks old. Please look at my lashes. I didn't even brush them out. Like, this is pre-brush them out. Y'all gonna see them after I brush them out. But 3 weeks old, this many lashes left. And I got a volume set because, well, Lily always tries new things on me and I love Lily for that. But she always knows what's best too. And if you live in the Atlanta area, definitely go to Lily. But I got a volume set this time. So then that way, even when time goes by, I still have a whole bunch of lashes and I don't have to go to Atlanta, like back to Atlanta every other week to get my lashes filled. Because I can't just be out here in Houston looking like a bum for like at least a little potato, you know what I'm saying? I can't be looking like that, so. At least a good month until these fall off, maybe max a one more week and a half until it hits a month, and it's still, this looks like great. Don't play with Lily. I'm kind of sad about what to do, like, where are we about to take these pictures now though, because it's definitely dark outside. Like, it's definitely dark. I'm just about to do a little of this just so I can hit the back of my kitchen right here. Just kind of brush it up. Let's go to the next question though. My favorite verse right now is 2 Peter 3:9. It just speaks about how God is not, like, I can just give you the actual verse, but I want to tell you what I get from it. The verse is like, God is not slow in keeping his promise. I think this is my favorite right now because that first part, He is not slow with his promise. He's being patient with you. One thing that I have really gotten to understand seriously since I've gotten here is like, God has made promises to me. You know, God has promised me many things that I will get in this life if I remain obedient. And there are things that I have to do as well. A lot of things. Lots of things I need to get done by Savion Jordan before she leaves this earth. So, I say that to say, God is going to keep these promises, but I have to do my part. And that's where that, oops, hold on, this is the wrong one. This is the straight one, I would do the curly. That's where that patience comes in. Like, God understands that we're going to fall short. God understands that we don't have it all together yet. God understands that there are going to be times when we don't listen all the way. There are going to be times when we might turn our back on him. There are going to be times when we don't pray every single day. But God is letting us know that he's patient with us. He's patient with us learning that, oh, we need to do this. He's patient with us knowing that, oh, this is the stuff that I need to get done. And I know that I'm living in this world with all of these distractions. He understands that. He sees these things as well. So he's patient with us. Because if he were to give us everything that we desire right now, come on now, you can't even handle $1,000. What you gonna do with $100,000? God can't give you that yet. Okay, like, let me show y'all this little process. This is what it looks like when you unravel it. You hook this up to the top of your ponytail. You can't really tell for with this. You hook it to the top of your ponytail. Boom, bow. Yeah. And you wrap that bottom piece around. To the front. Cool. This is about to be so cute. I'm so excited. They don't know what they just did. And then you are going to wrap this piece around the ponytail itself. Wrap it, wrap it, wrap it, wrap. Cool. And then get the bobby pins that were attached to it. And you secure the hair. This is so freaking cute. It's cute, y'all. Okay, I love it. Okay, bet. Like, then there it is. This is what it is. Okay, boom. Let me put this on because I don't even know if I'm taking pictures anymore at this point. Like, it's literally dark outside. So next and last, I'm going to brush my eyebrows and lashes. This is all I really do for my face, for real, like makeup. This is my makeup routine. I want to learn how to do makeup, but I don't know. Next question though, and it's the last question. Spend the night must have. So I guess like when I go spend the night at Corey's spot, I really just bring like my skincare routine is essential because you know boys, they'll have a 3-in-1 shampoo, conditioner, body wash, face wash, like why? And still be having perfect skin. Don't understand that. But like, nah. Like, Corey literally can wash himself with Dove. And he can, like, wash his face with that Dove, too. And I'm like, nah. I'm gonna need a little bit more. I'm gonna need a toner and some moisturizer and some serums. Like, nah. Definitely my skincare routine. And then I'll bring, like, a brush. You know, like, an edge control brush. Edge control. So, like, we go somewhere. I have, you know, just quick things to do my hair really quick. You know, clothes, change of clothes. I don't really bring pajamas. Like, I just usually just wear some of his shorts and a t-shirt. I'm about to put my accessories on. All right, BRB. So I have this butterfly necklace. So freaking cute. It got tangled up in a knot, like right here. And my nails are just not gonna allow me to get that out. So it just stays, the knot is with us now. And my bracelet is Pandora. Corey got me this like a while back. I don't remember which holiday or birthday or something like that. Something was going on. If you guys want to use my link to go shop, insert name here, definitely go do that. It'll be in the description box down below. I love my ponytail. It's super cute. Like, no. This is what I'm going to be doing these last couple of days with my straight hair. Like, I've been trying to figure out what to do while my hair is straight. Like, what hairstyles can I do? Because it's like, I'm all out. So this is going to be perfect. And you can also use my code Savion for 15% off. Go get you a ponytail, whatever, girl. Hey. Sup. The fit. It's cute. That's all I got for y'all today. I appreciate y'all watching me, sending me questions on Instagram. I thank you guys so much. Love y'all so much more. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. Follow me on social media in the description box down below. If you do want to see the pictures that I take, because if anything, we could just take some pictures in our house or something. Like, I could do something quick. Follow me on Instagram for that to see my skincare routine. Follow me on TikTok. Make sure you shop. Insert name here for the ponies. Use my code Savion for 15% off. And use my link in the description box down below. And I will see y'all in the next video. Bye. Yeah.